Okay, video three in my Deliveroo series. In this video, I'm going to have a good look through the Deliveroo Germany website. I'm going to try and find out what's causing them to have problems getting their keywords indexed and ranked. In my last video, I discovered they have indeed got less links than the competition, but that doesn't explain why they have so few keywords indexed and ranked. That this points to a technical problem. So I'm going to dig through the site. Now, before I get into that, I just want to make a quick comment about this main image here, this Sloppy Joe hamburger. Now, I get it. They probably sell more hamburgers than any other item on the delivery site. The thing is, people do like hamburgers. A lot of people like hamburgers. But I wouldn't use this image because it's a little bit inaccessible for some people. What if I'm Hindu? We do have a lot of Indian people in Germany these days. What if I'm a vegan? What if I'm a vegetarian? What if I'm a Muslim? What if I'm a Jew? Okay, we've got the bacon, we've got the cheese, we've got the meat, we've got the white bread. You know, I just wouldn't use this image. Just because it's your most popular item, I still wouldn't use it because it's going to turn some people off. I would have something that's a little bit more accessible to everyone, perhaps a meal where you can't tell whether it's tofu or chicken or whatever, as opposed to this hamburger. It's probably only a small thing, but for me, first impressions, well, they're important, aren't they? All right, so I'm going to get into the tech stuff. So I've used Screaming Frog SEO Spider to crawl the site. Great little tool. This allows me to see the website as if I'm Google. So I'm crawling as if I'm Google Mobile, so I'm pretty sure that I'm seeing the site the way Google Mobile is. It's possible that Deliveroo is detecting my IP address here and is serving me different results than what they serve Google proper, but I don't think they are. That's quite a lot of work and also carries a lot of risk, so I think I'm just seeing what Google's seeing. So all right, where do I start? Look, the first thing I do is I check the status codes of the crawled pages. I want to find 404s, 503s, those sort of things, pages that just don't work, and I have found a few. All right, so these are different menu pages that don't work. Alright, so let's have a look at the 404 pages. So the 404 page itself is not a very useful page, okay? So if I'm on Deliveroo's site and I get a 404 page, I don't want to have to click on something to then go and do something. I'd like to have a food search. Oh, sorry, doesn't seem we've got that result. Would you like to search for a restaurant here? Here's some fabulous restaurants. Something like that. This very generic 404 page where I can't do anything except go to their homepage, that's one more click for me, and I don't think that's a good idea. I would even dynamically deliver content based on what this page showed before. So if I knew that was a particular style of restaurant in Friedrichshain, I'd say, oh look, sorry, it doesn't look like we're delivering from there anymore. How about these other Asian restaurants in Friedrichshain? Maybe they will tempt you. I'd do something like that. But what else? Okay, so I'm looking at the in-links. Now that tells me where these pages are being linked from, yeah? So if I look down here, I can see the in-links are not actually coming from the main Deliveroo site, they're coming from the Deliveroo blog site. So I'm going to open that up. Alright, so Deliveroo has got a blog where they talk about just topical and fun topics, trying to get rankings for likely search terms. Top 11 picnic spots in Berlin. That's a great topic because that is something that people are interested in, especially in the warmer months. So yeah, here's some great places and you can get food delivered even to the picnic perhaps. But the problem is they write about this restaurant Fabu, and they're not working with Deliveroo anymore, so that is a dead link. I wonder if I can just quickly find it. So is it Fabu? All right, so this one here is dead. They're not delivering there anymore. So what I would do is I would come back, I would search through all of these blog articles, and I'd come back and I'd swap in a different restaurant, something similar. Yeah, so you keep the continuity of the article, keep the integrity, but just don't link to a dead restaurant. Linking to the dead restaurant, oh, what does that do? Well, for starters, takes me to a page where I can't order, so I'm not having a good time. It also devalues the actual Deliveroo blog. Let's see. Let's go back to the blog. One moment. I mean, if the... Oops, wrong one. We want in-links, don't we? So if the blog itself builds up a bunch of dead links. That means Google's going to place less value on the rest of the links in the Deliveroo blog site. So best to keep them out, and best to not be losing any page rank, any link juice down dead links. If you're collecting link juice, because this is a useful blog, you want to be funneling as much as you can to the end destination where people can actually order. So certainly I'd be fixing that. Now, that is a problem, but it's not their main problem, okay? There's just not enough 404 errors. Look, there's only a few hundred for that to be the problem. So then I'd be looking at 301s and canonicals. All right, so that's all these pages that are non-indexed. Yeah, so almost half. Where did we get up to? So 12,000 out of, well, not almost half, but it's certainly a lot. All right, so we've got some problems there. Now, I'm not going to go through my process in this video. I'm just going to show you what I found. All right, so here's one of their restaurants. And what's going on here is, this is the German page, this is the English page, and Deliveroo is using a canonical tag to tell Google, don't index either of those. Instead, index this main menu page. Okay, why do that? Look, I don't know for sure. What I'm guessing is, the information is supplied in German, it's translated into English for Deliveroo's users, and that makes sense. I mean, there's going to be a lot of people like me who'd prefer to search in English. But Google says, look, if you're going to auto-translate your content into another language, don't let us index it, because we can tell. And we don't want auto-translated content in our index. Otherwise, you could just get the content in one language, auto-translate into every language on the planet, present that to Google as if you've got this massive useful site, when you don't really, okay? You've really only got unique content in one language. So yes, you shouldn't present those to Google, but the way this is being done doesn't make any sense to me. For starters, I wouldn't even let Google find the English pages. If you're letting Google crawl them but not index them, you are still losing some link juice. You lose some link juice on every page that Google can actually get to, whether it's no index, whether it's canonical or not. But on top of that, look at this. They're saying, look, don't index this page. Canonical says go to this page. But then, once Google gets there, yep, Google is told, no, this page has moved. Look, it's got a 301 permanent redirection. Go and index this page. So look at that. It's a loop. So Google doesn't know what to do. It gets here, is told not to index it. Gets here, told not to index. In both cases, told to go here, told not to index it, told to go back to here. So yeah, this is a really big problem. Very confusing to Google. Google won't know which page to index. It won't know where to leave the page rank. I think this will be causing lots of problems with the integrity of the site. I would certainly fix that. I wouldn't let Google find this page at all. And I wouldn't have a 301 on this page. Just let Google read it. All right, what else can I tell you? Let's have a look at these pages. And let's talk about the actual quality of the page. All right. Okay, so I come to this page. I've got a single image. Don't have images of more than one item of food, so I'm not really personally bonded with it. I can't see any reviews. I've got this 92% satisfaction, but what does that even mean? I've got three euro symbols, which I don't even know what that means either. Are they kind of a medium price or? Okay, so look, I do understand a little bit about what's going on here. Okay, Deliveroo doesn't want to put its restaurants offside by having reviews on the page, because the reason for a bad review might be nothing to do with the restaurant. It could be a Deliveroo driver got lost, or was just late, or it was raining, or they might have had a spoonful of food there. I don't know. But a bad review could be something that's completely outside of the power of the restaurant to impact, and they'd be pretty cranky with that. So, look, I get it. Plus, every bad review has the potential to have a restaurant on your platform receive less orders, so why take that risk? Yeah, so Deliveroo is just not letting any reviews appear on the site, which is a bad user experience for me, because as a user, I want to know what people think about these curries. I want to know, are they really oily? Does the food come hot? Is it traditional, or is it very Germanified? I want to know this stuff. And so if I'm on a platform, I'm looking for that. And I know if I'm looking for it, other people are. And I know if other people are, Google says, look, if you don't do this, you're providing a lesser user experience than a platform that does allow the reviews. So this failure to allow the reviews on the pages and just have this percentage, that's a mistake. It's a lower user experience. There's less unique content on the page, but not going to get as many keywords ranked as the competition. But what else? Is there a way around this? What can they do? I think at the very least, have a multi-page form where you ask the user first about the food. Was the food good? Was the food hot? And then you only print on the page the comments about the food, not about the delivery. Okay, that's something that needs to go to customer success or customer support. They need to sort out why something wasn't delivered on time. And this allows you to split the problems that might be delivery-based or restaurant-based. And for me, as a user, I can then see which restaurants are very good. So all sorts of reasons to do that. Better user experience, more information, more unique content, etc., etc., etc. All right, what else can we find that was a problem? Ah, right, yes, this one. All right, bear with me. All right, so I opened up this restaurant. Okay, they're not accepting orders. So for some reason, yeah, this restaurant is not accepting any orders, and yet they're still in the sitemap. Okay, so if we come back here, you can see they are still there. All right. Yep, in the sitemap. Now that makes no sense to me, okay? If your restaurant can't serve any food, why let it appear in the sitemap? That makes zero sense. And if you do let them appear in the sitemap, why show their menu? Why not go, sorry, Chick-fil-A's not currently delivering. However, we've got some other restaurants that serve pizza or street food or sandwiches, etc., in your area. You might like to try these. Show pictures of those restaurants, yeah? So I've got a bunch of options which are likely to meet what I'm looking for. As it is, I've got nothing. These guys aren't delivering, and I've got to now, I can't even search on this page. What am I going to do? I'm going to, what, go to the home, have another search. The more clicks that are required to actually succeed in getting to something that I want to order, there's just more chance of me dropping off and going, oh, this is too hard, I'm not interested. So this is a mistake. It's a mistake that this page is in the sitemap at all. It's a mistake that it's got a menu that I can't order from, and it's a mistake that there's not at least something showing me options that I could accept instead now that I've come to this page and this option is off the table. All right, okay, what else can we look at? All right, so I had a bit of a look around because I'm in Punkow. I was going to order from a Punkow restaurant, so I just did a search for Punkow. I'll just grab that one. So I thought, all right, let's have a look what's going on in Punkow. All right, that's not entirely what I was looking for. Restaurants, let's go with restaurants. Bear with me. Okay, so these are the pages for the restaurants in Punkow. So that's the main one in English, that's the main one in German. And then there's all of these separate categories, okay? All right, now something kooky going on here, something very kooky going on here. Let's have a look at it. There's no H1, okay? Now the H1 tells Google this is what this page is about. Okay, so, all right, let's open it up. Okay, so we've got delivering to Punkow, but why only have delivering to Punkow? Why not delivering takeaway food or delivering food or home delivery food to Punkow? Why just only have those keywords in there? And then, if we inspect, you can see it's just a font. It's not a H1. So this is an important SEO factor. It's important. It's important information for Google. If you've got a H1, Google knows. Look, that's probably what this page is about. So to have that without a H1, I think is a mistake. All right. I think the titles are. I mean, order with Deliveroo. This is for branding. But you could just have Deliveroo. You don't need order with, and I would get more relevant keywords into the title. But then on top of that, we've got all of these pages, okay? And all of these pages, they don't... It doesn't even mention the cuisine, so that's Greek. Where's the Greek takeaway in Punkow? It's just a repeated... Wow, they're completely repeated titles. And all of these pages... These are all being presented to Google as if they're useful, standalone, separate pages. There's no canonical tag saying, hey, don't index me, come back and index this page. Don't index this one, come back and index that one. All of these pages are being presented to Google as if they're useful pages, which to me makes really little sense. They're badly presented. Let's see what the content's like. All right, delivery to Punkow. These are Greek. What, Greek burgers? Greek chicken? I don't think these are Greek at all. They don't even look like Greek. Some of them might be. Falafel? I think they've got some sort of a problem with their filtering. Hang on a minute. Let's see what else I can bring up. Indian? All right, so they're Indian at least. What's going on with Greek, guys? Alright, look at that. Okay, naught restaurants. So, yeah, this is terrible. So they've got no restaurants, no Greek restaurants at all in Punkow. Okay, so instead of actually saying, hey, we've got nothing in Punkow, nothing that delivers, they're saying, just order anything. So there's a bunch of random restaurants. And this is being presented to Google as well. So Google comes to this page, yeah, and sees people coming to this page. There's nothing Greek about it. Everyone's going to bounce. Google understands there'll be a high bounce rate on this page. Google understands there's no Greek content on here. So this is going to massively negatively impact the search engine rankings of Deliveroo, not just for Greek delivery, Greek food delivery Punkow, but across the whole site, because it's going to bring, it's sending this message across all of these pages that there's a bad user experience, there's a high bounce rate, and there's really a low percentage of actual content that's relevant to what this page is supposed to be about. So that's really, really terrible. Let's have a bit of a look at that. Greek bestseller in Berlin. Let's have a look what's going on with there. That. Alright, okay, so what's going on here is Deliveroo has written content pages to do with the cuisine and the main city. Okay, so Greek delivery, Berlin, and, you know, they talk a bit of generic nonsense about the food, and someone's decided that Google likes you to have content at the bottom and at the top, for whatever reason. Okay, where can we find you? Right, so these are the different areas of Google, and for some reason, it doesn't matter whether there's any restaurants in these areas or not. This sitemap still appears and creates a page for the users to go to, even if there's no restaurants. All right, so what they should be doing, let me see if I can find that page. It's just gone missing on me. All right, one second. All right, what they should be doing is setting a rule that if an area doesn't have at least four restaurants of that particular cuisine variety, say Greek, then don't have the link here at all. Where can we find you? You can't find us in Punkow, we don't exist. Or if you do want to have the link there just for continuity, don't have it as an href link, have it as a form submission which Google doesn't follow. So yeah, that solves that problem. What else can I tell you? Alright, so you remember how before we had this canonical rule, so that if something has been auto-translated into English, then Deliveroo is trying to prevent Google from indexing it? Well, why aren't they doing it here? It makes no sense. They're letting Google index the German and the English pages here when it comes to cuisine, okay, they're just not letting Google index the auto-created content when it comes to the restaurant menus and descriptions. Now, that sounds like a bit of a mistake. There's no continuity of the strategy. The strategy implementation on the other pages is poor, yeah, because they've got this loop. But here the strategy is just it's just forgotten altogether. So look, lots and lots of issues there. Okay, lots and lots of issues. Let's go through them. Let's go through them one last time. I think this image is a mistake. I think that you're going to increase your bounce rate by having that hamburger, because you've got certain people that just don't find that an accessible image. Deliveroo allows Google to index so many low quality pages. If you do that, you get thin content penalties, you get duplicate content penalties, you get bad user experience, high bounce rate penalties. So the way this is being done is wrong. Bad H1s, bad titles. What else did we have? We had this restaurant that you can't order from anymore. Yeah, it's still in the sitemap. What's that all about? I would remove that from the sitemap straight away. I would have related restaurants, nearby restaurants of the same food offerings here. I would have proper reviews, allow reviews about the food on the pages, and I would get rid of this canonical 301 loop, which is killing you. They're the main things. Look, I could spend another day on this, and I guarantee you I'm going to find a bunch more problems. But suffice to say, the problem that I'm seeing here, it's not even an uncommon problem, okay? I see this all the time. The problem is the product team makes something that works, and they go, yay, it works, and off they go. And then the marketing team is in charge of trying to market it and trying to rank it and try to do the performance marketing, but they're not focused on, really, is our website all that it can be? The trick here is to sit your marketing team down with your head of product and to have someone like me who can do this technical product marketing, product SEO, and go right through everything and go, look, we need to be better. We need to be the best, okay? Make a website that Google objectively is able to see provides a better user experience than the competitions, or you're just not going to win. You're going to have the problems that Deliveroo presently has. This video will now end. I hope you enjoyed it. I'll be making some more real soon.